Hey, this is Dr. Centeno, and we're seeing more patients send us emails about the idea of getting stem cell treatments for their brain problems by shooting those stem cells up the nose, or what's called intranasal delivery. And the idea is that the stem cells will cross through the thin bone in the nose that separates the nasal cavity from the brain. So the concept is, again, that you take stem cells, and almost like applying a nasal spray, you can go ahead and try to put those against the top part of the nasal cavity, where they'll go across that little bone or into the nerves, and through there they'll make it into the brain. Sometimes clinics actually try to place them on the side of the nasal cavities to get into the fifth cranial nerve, kind of same idea. So this is a paper that was published, and I think it's the most extensive one I've seen to date on this topic, where they actually track cells put into the nasal cavity of both rodents and a primate-like animal, and then they tracked where those cells went. And interestingly enough, there were a few that made it into the brain, but they ended up concentrating right at that olfactory bulb, or the bottom part of the brain, and or right next to that tissue, and they didn't go into the other areas of the brain. So there's good news and bad news about delivering stem cells this way. The good news is that some stem cells do cross into the brain. The bad news is this is likely only going to help people who have a hard time smelling, meaning damage in that olfactory bulb. So again, to review, they didn't see stem cells in the frontal lobe or in the parietal lobe or the occipital lobe or the temporal lobe, places where damage can occur, or basal ganglia, that kind of stuff, where common neurodegenerative diseases live. So small molecules produced by the cells could be getting into the brain. That's a possibility, or exosomes, etc. But again, the stem cells themselves are not making it into parts of the brain where they're probably needed. So this is a work in progress. This could be a good way to do this if it's dialed in a bit more. But right now, intranasal delivery of stem cells to treat your brain problems is likely not a reliable way to do this. If you want to do this, the only way to do that would be to float a catheter into the arterial supply of the brain where you want the cells. And most clinics do not have the expertise to do that. So be careful out there. Thanks so much.